Rev up your engines. Well, here we go. Customer just told me this Toyota Celica, it wasn't running. He said it was running, but he ran the battery down. It wasn't running that good. So the first thing we're gonna do is charge up the battery. Give it a good hour or so, so you get enough juice to really get some serious cranking. Then we'll try a little cranking and see what happens. No go. Well, let's take a look and we can see the number one spark plug sticking up in the air. Well, let's pull it out. Get a spark plug socket and see what's going on inside there. Something's messed up. Well, when I pull it out, I can smell fuel, so fuel's getting in there. Let's see if it's getting any spark. Now, a good way to check for spark is an old-fashioned timing gun. Just hook it up to the battery, one on positive, one on negative. Then take the inductive end, stick it on the spark plug wire. Then when you crank it, you see if you have any spark coming out. In this case, there isn't any. The light should have been flashing, flash, flash, flash. It's not. So we have no spark. Now the first thing you want to check for is a blown fuse. I got a circuit tester here. Keys turned on. We'll check them all to see if any of them are blown. Well, they all had 12.6 volts, so there's nothing wrong with the fuses. Now since there's no blown fuse, these engines are common for two things. Sometimes the timing belts break, then the distributor doesn't turn, and sometimes the distributor just burns out internally. So we're gonna take the distributor cap off and see if it's turning when it cranks. And we'll take the air filter housing out of the way so we have some working room. So we pull the distributor cap out of the way, then we're gonna look at the rotor while we crank the engine, see if it's spinning. There goes nothing. Well, now we know that the thing is spinning, so the timing belt's not broken. Here, the camera came in handy because I can't crank it and look at the same time. So I had to wait with you guys to look at the camera to see what happened, and it's spinning. Odds are the distributor's broken inside here electronically. Now, many things can theoretically go wrong inside the distributor, but here's a good test. When you unplug the main feed line here, we're testing it has 0 volts. Now we'll turn the key on, and we turn the key on, and give it power. Now we can see it has full power. So generally that means the distributor shot. That's a known flaw in this vehicle. As it ages, the distributor shorts out. Some guys try to repair them, but it's stupid. I just replace them with brand new units. Let's face it, it's a 27-year-old Celica. It's a nice looking car. You might as well just fix it right and just keep patching things up and then something else breaks. A 27-year-old distributor is not going to be something you want to patch up. Now, replacing the distributor on the Celica is easy. There's only 2 mounting bolts, 12 meter bolt here and on the bottom, and they only go in one of two ways, the correct way and 180 degrees off. So look at where it is on the car. In this case, the rotor's pointing down, so when we put it in so the rotor's turning down, and we unplug the electrical connections. That's it. Here comes the second bolt that holds it on. Now we'll just twist the distributor out. A little bit of wiggling and out it comes. Then you get the new distributor and wiggle that in so the rotor's pointed down, and in it goes. Then you plug the wiring in. Then you tighten the bolts on, then put the distributor cap on, and the bolts that hold it in place. Then we cross our fingers, stick in the key, see if it starts. And voila! So now you know how to fix your car when your ignition system craps out. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell!